Travis, bonjour.
Bonjour.
Something different. Do you believe in ghosts?
Ah, I don't know. I'm a bit agnostic. I think there is something to that whole supernatural thing. I've never really experienced it myself, so I can't say for certain. I'm a bit of a skeptic, though, I have to say.
The scariest movie you've ever seen is?
The Exorcist. I saw it when I was far too young, and it traumatized me. My brain was still wet and impressionable, and it still horrifies me to this day.
And that's why we're here today and you're doing this.
Yes, yes. You can see I'm working out all my demons with these films.
What's the craziest or scariest dream that you had and that you'll remember?
Ah, well, as an animator, one of the terrifying things is that I've become a puppet myself and I'm being manipulated by other human beings.
Wow.
So that's pretty scary.
What about Halloween costume? Because usually, you know, animators didn't know how to put on a show. So what's the best one you've ever had?
The best what?
Halloween costume.
I don't think I've ever had a great Halloween costume. I was always wearing the kind of the crappy thing from the local Walmart. So I don't think I have a really great story there.
You mean you don't wear Halloween costume now?
No, I don't do it now. I'm a Peter Pan in some ways, but I've moved beyond that side of it.
Animation movies for decades, it used to be about, you know, the princess and the prince who's coming to save the day. Do you feel that Norman is like the prince of today?
I think that thematically, Paranorman is, while it's certainly not kind of a standard fairy tale sort of thing like you found in the classic Disney fairy tales, I think that there are elements that are reminiscent of those types of stories, in that when you look at things like Pinocchio, when you look at things like Snow White and Sleeping Beauty, Disney really was able to capture that perfect blend of darkness and light, of intensity and warmth, of kind of scary stuff and fun, humorous stuff. And that's the sort of tradition that we tell our stories in, and we find by doing it in that way, these things are more powerful. They have a dynamism. They have an up and a down that allows people to experience a powerful story in a kind of a very interesting and undulating way. So while he's not a standard hero, he comes from that long tradition of storytelling in that dynamic way.
Can you relate to him? Were you that kid? Were you bullied in school, or were you having other girls?
I can relate to Norman. I was a bit of a misfit. I was a bit of an outcast. I think that's kind of par for the course when someone is an artist or an animator, that they, you know, they were not the captains of the football team. They were the kids who got shoved in the gym lockers. So I certainly found a lot of myself in Norman. I was a lot like him growing up. I didn't see ghosts, but I was weird in different ways.
What's your favorite animation movie of all time?
Ooh, that's a tough question. There's so many great things. I think if I look over the last like 15 to 20 years, I think the best animated film, other than Paranorman and Coraline, of course, was The Iron Giant. I think Brad Bird is an extraordinary filmmaker, and that film moved me to tears. It was a beautiful film.
It's interesting because for the young generation, I don't know, for you as a kid, that's what I'm asking the question, it feels like today, if you're 15, 16, and wants to be in animation, you can dream about it, you can do it. When I was a teen, that was just a dream because there were no way that could happen. How could you explain the change, and what was the process for you?
Yeah, it certainly when I was growing up, the idea that you could make a living doing animation was just nonsensical. There's no way that could possibly happen. And part of that was that there weren't that many places making animation in the 70s and 80s. Now, you know, with animation becoming as popular and as successful as it is, there are a lot of different animation houses that are making films, making television shows, making commercials. There are a lot of different avenues for young and up-and-coming artists to kind of to find work for themselves. And because of technology, it's had a democratizing effect. People can find the software that we use to capture the frames in this film and download it off the internet. People can grab a camera from a camera store and use the same camera that we use to shoot this film to shoot their own films. There's so many resources out there with the internet and everything else for people to learn how to do this that you can just learn by doing. When I was younger, it was just kind of a trial and error sort of thing, and you were isolated because we didn't have that sort of connectivity. But I really think because of technology, people have opportunities now that they've never had before, and that's a great thing.
Merci beaucoup, Travis.
Merci.